We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Coming in 5'5", 135, with Sound High, reporting to Sports Live, Miss L.A.D.Y. Sporting with Lady J is up in the building. Sporting with Lady J is up in the building. Sporting with Lady J is up in the building. Feeling the millions that last was feeling.
Oh, who's the beast to the east, the best in the west, the legion in the region, better than the west. Lady J is up in the building. Lady J is up in the building. Lady J is up in the building.
Feeling the millions that last was feeling.
L-A-D-Y-L-A Talk Live.
Yay, everybody. How's it going? I am so excited for today. I'm all laughs, just super ecstatic and excited. I am Lady J. Welcome to Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live. I am broadcasting live through my affiliate station, Las Vegas Talk Live. So yay to Las Vegas Talk Live. Hey! So you can follow me, Lady J, on Twitter at Hollywood Lady J. Again, I say at Hollywood Lady J. Also, like me on Facebook under my Facebook page, Lady J's Wild World of Sports. And please feel free to call into the studio here, 323-247-7443. Again, that's 323-247-7443. I just want to say really quick, last week, you guys, I had the MLB trainer, Alan Jaeger. And we were talking a little bit about how we first met. We met through my friend Amy, who did a show with me on Discovery Channel called iCaveman. And as I promised, I would show you pictures from iCaveman. So here you go. There's a picture of me and Amy in the wilderness. We had to live in Colorado for 2 weeks like cave women. And then there's me, always a fashionista. I turned in my long pants and made shorts out of them. After 7 days of long, dirty pants that I can't really wash, I had to make shorts. So that was from when I did iCaveman, 2 weeks living in the wilderness. So shout out to Amy Pasentino. I told you I would do that. And also, I would like to thank my sponsors, Mixed Chicks. I keep getting this question. They're like, oh, Mixed Chicks, I've heard of them. Can guys use it? Yes, Mixed Chicks actually makes guy products. It's called His Mix. I have a friend in the studio today, Dan, and he asked me about that. Yes, Mixed Chicks makes products for men called His Mix. And products for children, too. So please check out Mixed Chicks. Go to mixedchicks.net, mixedchicks.net. Today's show, very fun, very exciting. We have an Olympian in the building. Woohoo! That's all I'm saying. An Olympian is in the house and coming up. Yeah, you guys get that? Okay, so today's show, I keep telling you it's exciting. It is very exciting. First, I have Mr. Dan Tana, who is a comedian and bail agent, in the house with me today. Then I am very happy to say I have a friend of mine who I've known for years, I want to say, since I was a young lad, Miss Lashinda Demus, silver medalist at the 2012 London Olympics in the 400 meter hurdles. Miss Lashinda Demus. And also, we have a very special interview from Cincinnati Bengals, Manny Lawson. He will be phoning in as he prepares for his game tonight against the Green Bay Packers. So today is just a really awesome show, fun-filled show. I'm going to bring Dan on in really quick. Mr. Dan Tana. I'm sorry. I'm going to bring Dan on. Hey, Dan.
Hey.
How are you doing today?
I'm great. How are you doing?
I'm doing awesome. How about that?
Yeah, so
You wanted to talk about these crazy, like the strangest laws in the world, right?
Well,
here.
First, I want to say I really like that shirt you have on.
Oh, thank you. Did you guys get the Olympic sports team USA shirt?
I like that shirt. Oh. It's really cool.
So, the strangest laws in the world?
Yes, I want to hear about this because you have some of these crazy, like weird laws that nobody has heard of.
Yeah.
But you're going to tell us here live on Lady J's Wild World of Sports.
Uh-huh. Ohio, because Manny's from Ohio.
Yeah, let's talk about Ohio.
He plays for the Bengals.
Okay, yes, let's talk about Ohio.
So it is against the law to roller skate without first notifying the police.
In Ohio, it's against the law to roller skate without notifying the police.
Yes.
What happens if the policeman's on roller skates? I just want to know.
I mean, I guess he would first notify his boss.
Who needs to notify the police about being on roller skates? If that was in California on Venice, it'd be a hot mess. That's all I'm saying. Everyone in Venice is on roller skates.
Well, people don't care about these laws, I guess.
I heard you had something about something about spitting. What about spitting? The spitting law.
The spitting. Now in California.
Oh, California.
It is illegal to spit in public with one exception.
What's the exception?
Unless it's on a baseball diamond.
So I can't spit unless I'm spitting on the baseball diamond, or do I have to be physically standing on the baseball diamond?
Basically anywhere in the field, I would say, but I'm not a lawyer. I'm only a bail agent. So
only on the diamond, baseball diamond.
I mean, I'm guessing. That's my guess.
I want to call up some of my Dodgers and see if they knew that. I bet you they didn't even know that.
Well, a lot of people don't care about the law.
Well, apparently these laws aren't enforced. That's what I'm saying. Okay, what about this one about riding a bicycle?
In California, it's illegal.
All these laws are illegal. Right? Yeah, they're laws. I'm just saying, they're all illegal. Okay. Anywho-y.
To ride a bicycle, Janisha, inside of a swimming pool.
What?
It's tons of fun.
That's a lot of fun.
It is tons of fun.
That could have been like synchronized swimming bicycling kind of. So no riding the bicycle in a swimming pool.
It could easily be in the Olympics.
What about on the diving board?
I cannot answer your questions at this time, but maybe one day I'll bail somebody out and I'll be able to answer.
I know you have a lot. Oh, what about the elementary school student one? I want to hear about that.
In Fresno, California.
In the middle of nowhere, aka Fresno.
It is illegal.
Okay.
For elementary schools to host a poker tournament.
Why would... Oh, gosh. I have so many things going on in my head
They could start the kids off early. These kids could be champions.
What are they starting them off early? How is this related to... Oh, sports. Well, professional poker tournament.
Is that a sport? I don't know.
I think it's a sport.
Is that a sport?
Yeah, professional poker tournaments.
They have poker.
So they can host poker tournaments in Fresno at elementary schools.
Cannot.
But they can do bingo.
I don't know.
What's the difference?
I'm just saying.
Okay. Only if I was in jail and I was calling you and I needed to get bailed out.
Yeah.
Remember, we're going to talk about some of these athletes that have called you and needed your services.
Well, I have to keep names quiet.
But you don't have to keep their teams private. Okay, one more, and then we're going to go to break. I want a good one. What about the father and the son thing?
Oh. In
Georgia,
it is illegal for...
I'm mad that you keep saying illegal. These are laws, Dan.
I'm
You're getting
to
like,
get
in Georgia,
across.
It is legal. Yeah, okay. In Georgia.
For a father
to
play catch with his son in the city.
In the city of Dublin, in the state of Georgia.
Yes.
Where they have all the peaches in the world.
Yeah, wait,
it's illegal for a father and a son to play catch.
Yes, exactly.
In public?
In public.
That's so sad.
That is...
I mean, if he can't play catch with his son, or the son can't play catch with his father in public, I mean, then what is he supposed to do?
I'm 100% sure. Oh, you know what? Actually, it's okay. So it's in the city street.
Oh, okay. I'm in public. Well, it's, actually, the city street is still public.
Yeah.
It's not like it's a city street that's closed off.
Yeah. Backyard is fine.
Backyard. The backyard is fine to play catch. Yeah, that's, he's getting the fundamentals of how to be a team player and do sports, and he can't do it in the streets.
I'm sure. Some, I don't know kids about these laws. Cry all night.
No one's upholding these laws, apparently.
Cry.
We need.
Asleep.
I need you to find out if actually people have been ticketed for not following these laws. That's what we need to find out.
You know, I'm sure people don't listen to these laws.
That's what we need to find out. So yeah. So we're gonna come back to Dan with some more of these funny laws next in the studio of Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live, broadcasting live through my affiliate station, Las Vegas Talk Live. We will have Miss Lashinda Demus. I'm gonna show this picture one more time. It's just amazing. It's just amazing. Yeah, we're gonna have Miss Lashinda Demus in the studios, and that's about it. Also, again, I would love to thank my sponsors. Shout out to Miss Kim and Wendy and Brad and the whole Mixed Chicks family for sponsoring Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with Miss Lashinda Demus. All right. Thank you very much.
Jim Johnson, this bad boy. Yeah. Let's go.
Show stopping at the letter. The red shining with the open. Hydraulics make our heads go mad. Hair blowing in the breeze. Yo, we superstars. Put in the keys, make that engine hot. Three in the back, one in the passenger. Slow creeping, cause we look back fly. All the boys trying to taste our candy pie. We in the car.
The rainbow.
Yes, I am going show stopping. How about that? I'm going show stopping, but the show does not stop. How about that? I don't know how do you make that connection, but I thought it was clever. So Miss Lashinda Demus is, like almost everyone else, caught in a little bit of that 405 traffic, but she is on her way here. I just want to show this picture of her. I think this is such a hot photo. This is so powerful. Photo is awesome. Wait,
who is that?
Lashinda Demus.
Oh, that looks like you.
That's Lashinda Demus. I wish I looked like that. How about all those muscles are very clearly defined? How about that? That is such a hot photo of our U.S. silver medalist in the 400 meter hurdles at the London Olympics. Yeah. Oh. And I see you over there rocking your Olympic shirt, Dan.
Yeah.
With your medals and stuff on there. Cool, huh? Now, I know you had some stuff about some running on these little funny facts of yours.
Running, you know, I never found running.
You did say something. You had something about running. It's illegal in, you know, Altadena to run to the Rose Bowl or some crazy stuff you had up there.
You know, I've been trying to, you know, trying to dedicate this to the sports today, but
yes.
Some of them don't have to do with sports. This one does.
Okay.
A man may face up to 60 days in jail for patting a woman on her derriere.
A man may... Dan, hello, that's called sexual harassment. We all know that.
It's a major part of sports to pat a player on the derriere.
Dan. First of all, men and women don't play co-ed. How about that?
Well, it doesn't really matter. As long as it's a man rooting for another player. If it's a woman or a man, it doesn't matter. Spank that butt and...
No. Spank that butt. What would sports be? But you can't... you cannot do that. If you're a male and you're coaching a women's team, you're not going to hit the woman on the butt.
Not a coach. Maybe not a coach. Okay. I did say that earlier.
Yeah.
But, I mean, just as in support. Nobody's ever said, we have to ask Lashinda.
Yeah, we're going to ask Lashinda. And I think she's going to give you a run for your money with this answer.
All right, we'll ask.
Coming up over here with this, it's illegal. Yeah, okay. Move on to the next one. I don't like that one.
Okay.
Sounds like sexual harassment to me. Yeah.
It is illegal. to shoot any kind of game from a moving vehicle unless the target is a whale. A whale.
A moving vehicle.
Yes.
So speedboats, jet skis, sea-doos.
I guess, you know.
So it's okay.
My guess is as good as yours.
Where would a whale be other than in the ocean?
We
won't just see him riding down the streets of La Brea. I mean, so...
Maybe a lake. I don't know. A river.
A river.
I don't know. The bay. In the bay.
The bay.
Don't they get?
Yeah, but in a moving vehicle.
Ah, like
it's
a,
okay if I can't. Okay, I'm shooting.
Maybe
any type
if
of
you're
game.
You're on the bridge.
Oh, maybe
the whale
like
is down there.
Well, maybe okay. So maybe
he
like in the Bay Area.
At you.
Well, you know, in the Bay Area, like in Orinda, where they have those wild turkeys that crossed over and stuff. Maybe.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
I have wild turkeys out in front of my house.
Okay.
The Oakland Hills.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, these are too funny. I've never heard of these laws. Okay, I want to hear about this one where tell me. I can't even think of it.
Oh, what are we talking about?
It was one that was really funny, and I was like, what the heck? And I told you about it
earlier. Oh, talking about roller skating?
No. I mean, you have your info right there. How about you?
Well, I have another one I could just throw at you.
Okay,
from
do
Montana.
That one.
Oh, you know,
it was
in
Montana.
Michigan, I don't think this one we didn't talk about earlier.
Okay,
today,
let's talk about it then.
Montana.
Mm-hmm.
It is illegal for married women to go fishing alone on Sundays.
Okay.
And it is illegal for unmarried women to fish alone at all.
So then it's legal for married women. So that makes it legal for married women to go fishing with someone else.
With their husband, I suppose. I don't know the answers. I am, you know.
It's, oh my God. Why would it? Okay. I don't even want to go into that.
I'm not a lawyer.
Okay. How did you get into bail? How did you become a bail agent?
My uncle owned a bail agency, sold it in like 2008 or something like that. But, previous 2003, I started working for him.
Okay.
You know, I've known about bail all my life because of him.
Actually, can I tell them how I was at your house during the Super Bowl that was in Phoenix, Arizona?
I thought you were going to lie and okay, say, no. Can I tell them how you bailed me out?
No, I wouldn't lie. Well, no, Lady J has never been arrested, never been in jail or anything like that. Everyone knows Lady J just has a really smart mouth. But I've never been arrested or in jail or anything. So I wasn't going to lie. Why would I even make a joke about that?
Yeah.
Anyways, like I was saying, the Phoenix Super Bowl in 2008, that's where I seen Dan, Lady J's audience. I saw Dan at work. The phone was going crazy. There were so many athletes getting in trouble that weekend. It was unbelievable. There were fights everywhere. I'm not going to mention any names, but let's just say Arizona Cardinals do a lot of nonsense. Can I say that?
I can't let you say that. I don't know.
We're not going to say any names. That's all I'm saying. Yeah, but that weekend was very busy with a lot of phone calls to the Dan Tana household for bail. How does, how do they get the money for all of that? Like, if I'm calling, you know?
Well, we basically, we talk to the mother or father, you know, or the friends or family, somebody that loves you will call them and get them to put some money down on the bail and bail you out.
How much?
Depends
on the crime.
Yeah, maybe a couple percent of the bail amount to get started.
What about like a petty theft?
I don't know. It's always different. Depends how many times you did it.
Oh, so if you have a record, then it's more.
Yeah.
Obviously.
Definitely.
Oh, right. Definitely. Have you had any killers call you? Or killer relatives, I should say.
Well, you know, like people call for like, people call that, you know, are in trouble for murder or something like that, if that's what you're talking about.
Of course. Oh, Dan, I just said killer. But okay, and murder. Synonym. Yeah. Hello.
And I don't know, you know, if they did it or not. You know,
yeah. Well, it's not your job to try to figure out if they're, you know, guilty or not guilty.
Right. Right. But of course, you know, I don't like to bail somebody out that's like a murderer, child molester, and did all kinds of stuff. And then they call me to bail them out, and their bail's like $5 million, and their mother never trusted them anyway. You know? And even their best friend is like, well, I don't know, you know.
So who do you like to bail out then?
Well, little old ladies trying to cross the street without, you know, while they're jaywalking.
While they're roller skating and didn't notify a cop. How about that? Any old ladies outside roller skating, listening to Lady J on your iPad or iTunes phone, or and you didn't notify that cop, call us at 323-247-7443. I have a bail agent here in studio who can help you out.
Oh, maybe this is the one you were talking about. California, it's illegal to skateboard through a library or a courthouse. But I find it very meditational to skateboard, very relaxing. It could ease the pain going to court, you know, speeding ticket. Today I got a ticket.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Dan got a ticket today, and Lady J had to go to court today.
I know. She was in court, and I was outside getting a ticket.
Lady J had to go to court today.
Wouldn't have been very nice to relax on a skateboard. Meditate all the way
and skate through
through the courthouse.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, who's making up these laws?
How about I did see someone roller skating though on the sidewalk down Ocean Boulevard, but see, that law is legal here in California.
Okay.
Yeah,
in certain places.
Yeah, certain places.
Okay.
Yeah, too funny. Yeah, speaking of the tickets and stuff. Wait, I want to hear that one more. One more. This is too good, too funny, too interesting.
Now I got a little bit out of sight of the sports arena.
I think we can tie it in. Shoot at me.
All right.
Oh, wait, I'm out of well.
Well, if Kit Kat was here, do they know Kit Kat? You talk about Kit Kat.
You know what? Thank you for introducing my dog to the Lady J's listening audience. Everyone, I have a long hair chihuahua named Kit Kat. She is the cutest thing on the planet. I just want to eat her. She's so cute. Oh, my gosh.
She greets you at the door every
time. She's so adorable. So, yeah, now they know Kit Kat. Oh, Kit Kat will be joining me in studio in 2 weeks. So, everyone will get a chance to meet Kit Kat. She's adorable. So, shout out to Kit Kat. Oh, shout out to your dad, Roger Tana. And your brother, Dalton, okay? How about that? We're going to give them some shout-outs.
Of course.
You didn't give him a shout-out. I gave him a shout-out. Of course. Yeah, of course you're late. Okay. Anyway, so, that's for you, Roger and Dalton.
A quick one for Kit Kat.
Okay.
In California.
Yeah.
Animals may not
be
mate.
Eaten. Oh, okay. Sorry.
Mate publicly. Okay, publicly within 1,500 feet of a school, a church, or a bar.
Animals can't mate.
Kit Kats.
Okay.
Okay.
Kit Kat.
Cannot.
Leave Kit Kat out of this, okay?
No, Kit Kat
okay.
too.
So animals cannot mate in public. Basically,
you can't picture Kit Kat mating.
No.
Yeah, I don't want to either.
Why would oh gosh, okay, I don't even know where to go with that.
Well,
one.
It's just
this
crazy,
is a law in California.
You don't
what's
have to
the
go
city
anywhere. No, all over California.
Really?
Anywhere in California. Yes,
I've seen pets mating all the time.
But is it within 1,500 feet
oh my
of
goodness.
A school, church, or bar?
School, church, or a bar. Yeah. You know what? I saw two alley cats right outside the room. I saw two alley cats outside of a bar in Belmont Shore. I kid you not. Yeah. That's funny. And the owner was roller skating.
Through an alley. I don't know. That
yeah,
might be
that's
okay.
all I'm saying. Oh, my gosh. So I understand Lashinda, Miss Demas in studio. I think I've seen her. She was in studio. Miss Demas might have. I thought I saw a glare. Yeah, I thought I saw Miss Demas run straight in here. So,
Oh, you know, in Florida, though.
Okay,
in
let's
Florida.
Florida. What's going on in Florida?
A husband may not kiss his wife's boobies.
Okay, sports.
Yeah,
Lady J's Wild World of Sports.
All right,
sports.
Back to the sports.
Okay. Oh, my God.
It is
God.
Ill in South Carolina. It is illegal.
South Carolina. That's, oh, no, sorry. I thought
Lancaster
that was
County.
Okay, Lancaster
South
County.
South Carolina.
South Carolina.
To dance in public.
It's illegal to dance in public in South Carolina. You know why?
Why?
Because South Carolinas don't have rhythm. I'm just kidding. Speaking of South Carolina, that is where Lashinda went. Lashinda went to college at University of South Carolina. So I want you to save that. We're going to talk to her about that rule.
Okay.
Because I don't know how true that law is or if they really uphold that law.
Oh,
you
can't
dance
ask
in public?
She broke the law.
I'm going to ask Lashinda if she broke the law. Were you dancing in public over there on campus, Lashinda? Yeah, we're going to find out.
We'll ask her before we tell her the law. How about that?
Oh, yeah. And then you're going to do a citizen's arrest on her. Oh, my gosh. So, yes, everyone, this is Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live, broadcasting live through my affiliate station, Las Vegas Talk Live. I'm here with comedian and Bell agent, Mr. Dan Tana, and we are going to go listen to some Ely Goulding, Lights, which is one of my favorite songs out right now. I tell you guys that every week because it's true. It's one of my favorite songs. We're going to listen to some Ely Goulding, and then we're going to come back to Miss Lashinda Demas. So this is Lady J's Wild World Sports here on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk. Okay.
I had a way then, losing it all on my own. I had a heart then, but the queen is
too hard to beat, and I'm not keeping now the strength I need to push me. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. You shine me when I'm alone, and so I tell myself that I'll be strong and dreaming when they're gone, 'cause they're calling, calling, calling me home, calling, calling, calling home. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. You shine me when I'm alone. Voices I play within my head, touch my own skin and hope that I still be there. And I think back to when my brother and my sister slept in an unloved place, the only time I feel safe. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. You shine me when I'm alone, and so I tell myself that I'll be strong and dreaming when they're gone, 'cause they're calling, calling, calling me home, calling, calling, calling home. You show the lights that stop me, turn to stone. You shine me when I'm
wait to get to this party tonight. Me too, but you are not coming with me looking like that. What? Your hair is a hot mess. It's frizzy, it's wild. You need Mixed Chicks.
What's that?
It's this incredible hair product called Mixed Chicks.
But I'm not mixed.
You don't have to be. It says right on the bottle, whether you're black, white, Asian, Latino, Mediterranean, or any glorious combination.
Is it alcohol free?
Yep, so it won't dry your hair out. Worked on weaves too. Bet you thought it was real.
Mixed Chicks, control your curls. Check out MixedChicks.net.
Mixed Chicks available at select salons, beauty supplies, and your neighborhood Target stores.
Mountain Valley Spring Water, since 1871, has been bottled at the source in Hot Springs, Arkansas. Twice named the best-tasting water in the world, Mountain Valley Water is naturally alkaline and bottled in glass, providing the perfect blend of nature's minerals, giving you a crisp, clean taste. To start your home and office delivery in Southern California, call us at 1-800-499-9982 or visit us online at www.mountainvalleywaterla.com. New customers will receive their first 2 5-gallon bottles free. Mountain Valley Water, the official sponsor of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane on LA Talk Live.
Hello, this is Lady J's Wild World of Sports, and I am so ecstatic and happy. We have an Olympian in the building.
Yay!
Yay, an Olympian in the building!
Yay!
Okay, so I need to do a warm welcome and introduction for this young lady. She's so amazing. So, our long-awaited arrival is here, Miss LaShinda Demus. the 2012 London Olympic silver medalist in the 400 meter hurdles. Hey, Lashinda.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Muy bien, ¿y tú? Come a little closer to the... Come a little closer. Okay, yeah. Okay. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. Enjoying the California weather. You know, it was kind of cold in London. So.
Oh. You kicked butt.
Yeah, I try to do. I try to do what I do when I get out there. I try.
Can I just say, personally, congratulations. And I knew, dang. I always knew you was going to be a star. Always. Always. From running, running against your behind. How about that? Running against Sorry? You in since a young lad, club track.
Yeah.
When you were at Wilson.
Mm-hmm. I remember Gar. You were
uh-huh. Yeah. Gar with my twin sister. And yeah. Now you have twins. Ha ha.
I love the twins.
How is it being a mom of twins?
It's fun. It's just comedy and confusion and tiredness and all that combined into one. I wouldn't have it any different, though. I love it.
Do you force them to dress alike?
Yes, I do. Until they tell me no, I will continue to dress them alike.
That's what my mom said with me and Jamia. I mean, it was dreadful. I mean, we finally asked at like 14. We're like, please.
Oh, I'm not going to go that late. Okay. That's sad.
Yeah, I know. It was sad. It was very sad. I was always in purple. Jamia was always in pink. But I was like, God, doggy, we have different styles, you know? Yeah, so.
Yeah, yeah. I won't let them go that far. But at least in third grade.
How old are third grade? What, 8 years old?
I don't know. They're five now.
Eight. Yeah. Okay. Oh, shout out maybe to nine. Dion Dante. Didi.
Dwayne.
Why did I say, where did I get the other one from? I was Dwayne so focused on Dante. Didi. Yeah, Dwayne and Dante.
D square, yeah.
Yeah, D square. Oh, my goodness. So, where's your medal?
Oh, you have the medal?
Of course. She has the medal.
Oh, wow. It's over there.
Okay.
You have it all the time?
Well, so many people, you know, I was coming in from customs from London and the security were like, can we see it? We see it in scan, you know, when they're scanning your stuff, we see it in your bag. Can we see it?
Oh, they were scared of it or they didn't know what it was or did it?
No, they knew what it was. Oh, okay, and they were like, can you show us?
Oh, okay. I'm like, whoa. Yeah, you know what? You should have walked through that scanner with that metal on and let it just ding all the way through.
Yeah, right.
Woohoo! Yeah.
Is it one of those things you can't touch or do I get to actually touch it?
No, you can touch it.
Sorry.
I'm nervous about that.
Oh, I thought it made a noise.
Nervous. That was me.
I thought it played music. I was like, what?
She got a special medal. It plays music and everything. Yeah. So amazing.
Heavy. Like, you can't really wear it everywhere you go.
No.
Okay. I want to see.
I'm one chain. Two chains, I'm one chain.
Okay, so let's talk about this. I want to see. Oh. I want to see. Oh, so cute. It's my favorite color, people. Didn't I just say I was forced to wear purple?
Oh, so now you like the purple. Which one is it?
Awesome, it's so cute. So amazing. Congratulations. Wow.
Thank
seriously.
You.
Wow. Now, this was not your first Olympics. I'm so tired of hearing people say you were in Athens.
Yeah, I didn't run well, but I was in Athens. I was young then. I was a junior in college, and that's when I made my first Olympic team. So, yep, I was in Athens.
And that was a huge accomplishment, too, in college to make the Olympics.
Yeah, I didn't know what to expect. I knew that I was capable of making the team then, but mm-hmm. It wasn't any pressure on me. I was the underdog, and, you know, people weren't checking for me. So I kind of ran just having fun, and I made the team.
It's awesome. I was rooting for you. I remember that. Yeah. I definitely remember that. And then 2008, Beijing.
Yes. I missed it.
You missed out.
Mm-hmm. I was coming back from my pregnancy, and, you know, I didn't have that juice left. I think I was training for so long, and my body just kind of went kerplunk on me. And that was the end of that, so I missed it.
It was meant to be.
I wouldn't say that.
No, because now this.
Well, now this, good. Somebody else had a chance, so I came back and redeemed myself. So I guess you can't say it was meant to be,
Came back, you know, better than ever.
Yeah, better. Mm-hmm. Better, faster,
slimmer. And speaking of, you look freaking amazing.
Well,
you look amazing. I mean, how strict is your diet, your workout?
Right now?
I mean, are you not following? It's not too strict right now?
No.
Okay,
gluten-free?
Not at all.
Are you gluten-free?
No, I don't eat red meat or pork in season. You know, I don't really, I don't drink alcohol while I'm competing. Yeah, so right now I'm doing all the sweets I can, having a couple of cocktails here. I'm enjoying my off time. I think it hasn't even been a full week yet, or I'm hitting a week. Yeah.
Do you have to go back and run?
No, I'm done for the season. You know, I'm trying to nurse back to being healthy. I wasn't healthy this year and suffered with a lot of injuries. So I said after the Olympic Games, I knew that before I even competed, that I would stop after that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So that's pretty good. But you're not stopping for training.
No.
Because we're going to see you in
2016?
Rio.
Yeah,
I'm excited. I'm
going.
I'm fundraising right now, trying to get some money so I can make it to Brazil.
I think you're like the 20th person that told me that. I'm like, the more the merrier.
Yeah, I'm really trying to get out there and be waddling in the sand and frolicking around.
Yes. With all the beautiful Brazilian women.
Yes.
They're beautiful.
Now, how was South Carolina? Because that's where you
went to college.
Yeah. Okay. We have
a couple of questions.
We have some questions for you because Dan was in here earlier telling us about some weird laws.
Blue laws.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's the craziest laws in the world.
And one of them was it was illegal to dance in public in South Carolina.
It's actually.
Yeah, no way. You know about that?
You knew
it's
that?
A lot of blue laws. They're called blue laws, so they don't really enforce them, but they were at one time laws. There's some other ones that I can't state, but it has to do with sex as well.
Another one
was that you can beat your wife at the state capitol building. Yeah.
You can beat the wife
on the stairs. Your wife there at the state capitol.
Yes.
So they're called blue laws. Yeah.
Blue laws. So mm-hmm. I was like, I wonder if Lashinda knew about that.
Oh yeah.
So you wasn't doing the stanky leg or none of that in South Carolina.
Oh, I did it everywhere.
You ever did it? Oh my gosh. That's funny. Oh my goodness, I can't believe this. Because you're so awesome in the 400 hurdles. I try to tell people 400 hurdles in the open four is totally different.
Totally different.
Totally different race. But do you ever like, I want to do the 4x4 relay? Because I thought that you would have ran the 4x4 relay.
Well, you know, this year they were really strong. And I can say for the first time, I felt that I didn't deserve to be on the 4x4 relay team. I felt that the people they chose clearly earned their position on it, and I was comfortable with that. Years before, I really felt that I should have been on some of those relays. And yeah, I always say that I'm available to run. I tell them, they know that I'm in the relay pool every championship.
Right.
You know, so they know that I'm there and they know that I'm available, but it's up to the coach, you know, to choose you. So,
because I'm like, you would have had another medal.
Yeah, it would have been another medal, but I really do believe that they put the best team out there this time. And especially with me, I was, you know, injured. I wasn't completely healthy, and I felt that the decision was right, and those girls were amazing. So.
Okay. Oh, cool. Because I was like, dang, why
I love them all, yeah.
Go Team USA.
Yeah, I love them all.
Now, what I want to ask you, you have done such an amazing job of, you don't see, you know how you have athletes, they're always in the news for some nonsense. Either they didn't headbutted somebody or they're driving drunk. I mean, how have you managed to stay in the clear, you know, out of the drama, out of this, you know, Allyson Felix, that Jenna Batarmos type crap that people didn't even know about track and field, and now all of a sudden they're glued to it. How have you done it?
I think I was a professional before. You guys see me in college.
Right. Yeah.
I ditched the bad times already, but you know, I have a family. I don't have time to do anything.
Exactly.
So I think that kind of works for the best. You know, I was pregnant at 23, so I was kind of young and I had to straighten myself out quickly and fast. So I think that kind of helped with me kind of avoiding doing crazy things. But I'm not some saintly person that didn't do anything in the past.
Well, I mean,
you know,
we
so,
all, right.
Yeah, I kind of just...
But you don't go around headbutting people.
No, but maybe in college I would have.
joke. We're taking it as a joke. But some people out there are scared of your muscles because you are very
Me?
Defined.
I'm so little.
You Well, I stood next to him, tiny, but yeah.
People, when they see me, they think I'm big because of TV. And then when they meet me in person, they're like, yeah. You're not as tall. You're not big. You're this little bitty. I'm like, yeah, I'm little. I hop over hurdles. I can't. Look, an elephant moves nowhere fast. So
an elephant moves nowhere fast.
That's what my mom said.
Unless he's on roller skates.
Maybe.
Are you going to have your kids do track? You want them to do track?
I want them to do whatever they're passionate about.
Uh-huh.
You know, at a young age, I was passionate about track, so I pursued that. And, you know, even being passionate, you don't feel like doing it all the time. So I went through a stage where I didn't even want to run track growing up. But so I will let them pursue what they're passionate about. And if I see that they're actually talented at it, I'm not going to let them quit.
Uh-huh.
So I think that's a job for the parent.
I want to show you this photo that I have of you from when you were a little.
Where is it? It's so cute.
Look, adorable. And you was kicking butt at that age. How about that? You was kicking butt.
We broke
butt.
A record at that age.
You was a sub bad on my thing. Wow. Or Bantam. Bantam. There you go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's adorable.
I remember that day, too. I remember doing the photo shoot and everything.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
What was you guys' team? It was
me, Nisa, Kiana, and Angel.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we were the bomb. We were good. They still haven't broke our record. It's still in the books.
Really?
4x4.
Still 4x4. But when did you first start doing hurdles?
I think I started doing them in the 7th grade.
Okay.
And it was just like my main focus was like the 800 then.
Uh-huh.
So I would do it every now and then. But in high school, I really just focused on, okay, hurdles is what I do.
Uh-huh.
So.
And did them very well. I mean, you was breaking records. Hold on. I have a little fact list on you. I don't know if I already told the audience, but Lashinda not only is a silver medalist in the 400-meter hurdles at London Olympics, but she's also the U.S. record holder in that event, too.
Yeah.
So shout out to you on that. So in high school, you were the national high school record in 300-meter hurdles
mm-hmm.
at Long Beach Wilson.
Mm-hmm.
And then at University of South Carolina, where you went to school, you're the world junior champion, mm-hmm. NCAA indoor champion, and then on and on and on and on and on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I kind of did every stage in my little running career, including a youngster. I kind of broke a record and I did kind of everything you were supposed to or what you reach for. So the only thing I have left is this gold medal in the world record. So,
and because I heard you have this bucket list, and two things are already knocked off.
Yeah, the American record and the world championship gold medal. Yeah.
The world championship gold medal, and the two things that are left,
world record and gold Olympic medal.
Okay, and we already know you're going to get that.
Yeah.
We know you're going to get that. Yeah, Lady J's Raw Award of Sports at LA Talk Live. We know you're going to get that. And we're going to get that in Rio.
Okay.
And I'm going to get my ticket so I can be in the stands watching you.
Oh, yeah, because that's crazy in that stadium. It's crazy.
Well, did you go visit any of the other sports?
I did not.
Really?
And I said that the next Olympics I will. You know, when I'm competing, I'm so closed off. I don't like doing anything but being around my family. That's what I do. I kind of shut off. And yeah, so I didn't go anywhere.
How much of your family was there? I mean, we saw the twins. They showed.
Yeah.
They were during your trial. It was so cute. They were like, go, mommy. They showed them on the TV.
Yeah, they were like trending on Twitter. It was weird. So the twins were there, my husband was there, my mom and dad, Ashley
Caffey,
my PR person, and a couple, her mom, Miss Pam, and a couple of family friends and aunties. Yeah, it was a lot.
So you had a whole little crew with you. You had
I think
entourage.
We had like 12 people total, I think.
Really? Mm-hmm. Shout out to Lashinda, the husband. I didn't even see the twins sneak in here. How about that?
We woke them up for their nap.
Yeah, I didn't see them in here. So shout out. Hey, twins. Hey, they're so cute. They're so cute. They're like, no, screw this. I'm going to keep eating this Teddy Grahams over here.
You better be happy. They're quiet. Did you see them on KTLA? You don't want no parts of that. Not today.
I do. I have a twin. So twins supposed to show twins love. If people want to reach you, how can they reach you?
Well, I'm on Twitter and at Lashinda Demas. You can follow me on my fan page on Facebook, Lashinda Demas Road to Gold. And of course, if you're looking for PR things, you can do Pure Perception PR. Is it?
Uh-huh. Yeah, it's Peer Perception PR. Yeah. Shout out to Ashley. Ashley's my cousin, people. How about that? Ashley's in the PR person. She's here. Yeah. But yes, yeah. And if any other way if they want to reach you?
That's it.
Okay.
Twitter, Facebook, that's everything.
Okay.
Ashley, Pure Perception.
What do you do when you're not like running and working out?
A lot of nothing.
Really?
Yeah. I like cooking. I like dancing. I like going out.
Dancing
to eat.
In public. Uh-huh.
I like dancing at home.
It's not South Carolina, so you
I know.
No, I'll dance at home. Like I like going to restaurants a lot. I like hanging out.
Do you do karaoke?
I do not.
Oh, you have to.
I will one day, but I feel that you should at least be able to hold a note. And I can't even do that.
Okay, so Lady J's, while we're at the sports, we're going to have a karaoke in about a couple weeks.
Oh,
actually,
okay.
It's
I thought you were about to say now.
No. In a couple weeks, but I want you to come back.
Oh, God.
Just spread it on
here?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It's going to be right there.
Right over there. Uh-huh.
That's too much pressure.
No. You'll love it. I promise you'll love it.
We're going to have a big potluck.
I can do potluck.
Oh,
you
see?
We got you were talking about that diet.
I like eating.
You were talking about that diet earlier.
I like eating.
Too funny. But yeah, I think this is like awesome. Do you have a rival? Do you have a rival? Who's your rival?
Good question.
No rivals. I guess they try to make the Jamaicans and myself rivals, but. Maybe we are low key, but
with the U.S.
Yeah.
Uh huh.
So, yeah.
But you
more
like,
people probably consider me their rival that I don't know.
Right.
That I don't know of. Wait,
I have a question.
Yes.
I didn't know you root for. Wait, isn't that the Jamaica flag?
Oh
on
my.
Your?
Yeah. Well,
yeah,
I'm
I
half
wasn't
Jamaican.
Gonna mention that, yeah. But since you did.
Thanks, Lashina. Thank you, Lashina. Yeah.
Well, since you mentioned it.
Yes, everybody. I'm half Jamaican, or what is it, Ashley? We're what, 1/8 Jamaican, half Jamaican?
So you Jamaican? Huh?
Yeah, I'm Jamaican. Yeah, Ashley over there got the Jamaican, but Jamaicans in the house. Yeah, family, but the dad's side is from Montego Bay, people. That's all I'm saying.
Ew.
Yeah. But yeah, so no, right? But you have always been like, I'm running against the clock, because really, that's mm-hmm. all that matters is mm-hmm. the clock.
Yeah, I feel that way. I mean, I feel if I run the race that I'm training every single day,
right?
That I honestly don't think I should lose. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'm running against the clock. I'm running against myself. I'm trying to prove myself wrong that I can do something perfect, mm-hmm. you know, that day. And so it's a lot to just see what your body is really capable of doing. And I like seeing that.
Yeah, because you see it. You see it changing.
Mm-hmm.
How do you? What's the change that's going to happen for Rio? Because now you have another 4 years mm-hmm. to add to all the changes you've already done.
Well, I noticed that you know, I am getting older, so I won't run as many meets, and my physio would move up a couple of notches. You know, taking care of my body is going to be the main thing to, you know, elongate this career for 4 more years. So
That's awesome.
That's what I'll be focusing on.
Okay, so you kind of knock out some of the meets. You don't do
right,
as many.
Right.
I got you.
To serve in my body.
That's an awesome answer. Yeah, that was really good. I didn't even think about that. And I did track. God doggy. Okay. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. I have one more picture to show you that I thought I showed this earlier, but I think this is so hot. Do you remember when you did this one?
Yeah.
You didn't like
great
it?
Great picture.
Yeah, it was fun. My knees were hurting on this little on a platform, and then there was like two people on each side, and they were dropping the flag as you know. It was just funny. It was funny, but yeah, that was a fun photo shoot.
Yeah,
that
that's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to say thank you so much for stopping by, showing Lady J's Bar World of Sports here some love.
Thank you for having me.
No,
we go way, way back.
Yeah, way back to like
LA Gears.
LA, way back like Babies and Pacifiers.
Yeah,
LA Gear. Is LA Gear still around?
No.
Oh, okay.
Thank God. LA Lights, LA Gear. We don't need any of that stuff.
So, any parting words you want to say to your? I know you have people listening mm-hmm. to the Lady J's Wild World of Sports audience. You have the floor. Anything
you
want
to say? I just, like I always do, I just want to thank everybody for supporting me. And I think you know, it's cliche to hear that, but people don't know how much it means to, you know, us competitors. Like, we really, really look for people that are supporting us and kind of helping us along. Just like when you're competing at a track meet and the stand, the fans are there. You run better when it's more people in the stadium watching you.
Exactly.
So it's the same concept. So I really do appreciate people that support me, people with me. I don't like the people against me.
As you should not.
But I thank everybody, so.
Awesome. Oh, it's just been an honor and a pleasure
to
have you in our studios. So one more time, this has been Miss Lashinda Demus, the 2012 Olympic silver medalist in the 400 meter hurdles, who is going to bring back gold in Rio 2016. How about that? So this is Lady J's Wild World of Sports. We're going to go back, sell a little soap, and then we'll have our interview from Mr. Manny Lawson of the Cincinnati Bengals as they prepare for their game tonight against the Green Bay Packers. So, Lady J's Wild World of Sports, right back. This is Lady J representing LA Talk Live. I am here with my buddy. I'm so excited. Mr. Manny Lawson, number 99 of the Cincinnati Bengals. How are you doing today?
I'm doing fine, Lady J, and yourself?
I'm doing great. Oh my goodness. It's been a while since I talked to you last.
It has been a minute. It's been a long time.
It's been like since your San Francisco 49er days, I think.
You know what? Since we did that interview and you really tried to challenge my double dutching skills. Yeah. It's been a while.
Oh, actually, I think that was a time when you were doing your Michael Jackson impersonation.
Don't hate. Don't hate. It should have been me. It should have been me instead of Chris Brown up there doing the Michael Jackson impersonation.
Wow. Actually, I agree with you. I totally agree. You wouldn't have cried.
I would have.
Really?
I would have cried through the entire thing. So actually, it's probably best that Chris Brown did do it. Kudos, Chris. Hey, Mike.
I know. How do you feel about that? Like, Mike, were you pro Conrad or are you anti Conrad?
I am. you know, I'm kind of neutral.
You can't be neutral. You got to choose a side.
Do I really?
Yeah. Either you want Dr. Murray to burn in hell, or you want him to just, you know, be walking on this planet like the rest of us.
You know, it's just sad, you know, because we lost a great, you know, a great person, a role model, an entertainer, and can we just leave him alone? let's just leave him alone. Like, you know, it's already said and done. We just, you know, let him go, leave him alone, and that'd be that. We just, you know, think about Mike and all his greatest hits. Even though I have like 9 of his greatest hits albums, they really don't change, but you always think there's something new out.
Yeah, that's funny. They change because like Will I Am like produces one track, and then like Kanye does one, and Akon does another one. But you know, Thriller and
How
Beat
about
It.
I, yeah, the new one with Rhyme Fest on it. That's actually pretty good.
Are you serious?
So serious.
What? I didn't even know about that one. That's funny. Yeah. How is your sister doing? I remember last time you saying she always be taking your clothes and stuff.
Lord have mercy, Jesus. It's funny. You just said that. She's calling me right now.
You're
like,
kidding.
I'm so serious. She's calling me right now. But we're not talking to her. We're going to act like I'm gone so she can get the voicemail, because I know she's calling me about something that's just very random.
Wow.
But no, she's actually doing very good. She's getting ready to graduate from grad school.
Congratulations.
So, you know, very proud of her.
Yeah, she deserves it.
Thank you. That was for me, right?
That's for the lost and brother and sister duo. How about that?
Okay, we can do that. We can leave her out. Yeah, I'm not going to tell her.
Too funny. So how's the weather in Cincinnati right now? Because in California, we're going through a heat wave.
Seriously?
Yeah, man. I'm talking triple digits. Like, we about 1 degree from hell.
No, stay indoors. By all means, stay indoors. And, you know, get some of the sunblock. Even though it kind of leaves the white residue on you for a long time, no matter how much you try to rub it in, you know, it's better because you just don't want the old wrinkles. But the weather over here is nice. You know, it's starting to cool down a lot. You know, it's very humid over here. One thing I do like about it is, you know, the thunderstorms, and we get a lot of rain. So, you know, I won't say I dance in the rain. And I won't say I go out and, like, really, like, watch the thunderstorms outside. I prefer to watch them indoors.
Uh-huh.
You know, actually, but away from the window, but I can, and like with like a little bit of the blind open so I can see through.
Oh, wow.
And see lightning and just say, I've seen it. So I can be like, yeah, there was a thunderstorm.
Did you hear about that? The race car fans that got struck by lightning?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, there were some fans. Actually, one guy died. They was at an event.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So you're right about that stand indoors thing with that type of weather.
Yes, no. Mother Nature is nothing to play with.
Yeah, you don't want to be out there moonwalking and get struck.
I'm telling you. Definitely don't want that to happen.
So, I know you're getting ready for your Green Bay Packers game. First of all, can I say congratulations? You guys are already 2-0 in this preseason. How about that?
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So what, how do you prepare for Green Bay, which is 0-2 and they're playing you guys? Because, I mean, some, you know how there's some teams people expect to just beat? You know, like for me, I just knew you guys was going to be the Jets. There was nobody on this planet that could have told me y'all was going to beat, I mean, wasn't going to beat them. I just knew that that was going to happen. How do you prepare for certain teams like Green Bay, who y'all facing, who hasn't won a single game yet?
Really, you have to prepare for every team pretty much the exact same way. Mm-hmm. Identify their weapons, identify their scheme, identify, you know, what areas, you know, they excel at, while also, you know, understanding and realizing, you know, what teams have exposed you on the previous week or the previous Sunday or the previous game. So, you know, ways that our defense was exploited by Atlanta. We have to correct those errors because we're sure that, you know, rest assured that Green Bay is also looking at that film and, you know, ways that, you know, Atlanta has moved the ball on us and will probably imitate those same schemes.
That's smart. Hello. Yeah, I was saying that was smart, and you didn't say anything.
What am I supposed to say? I just told you everything. You tell me I'm smart.
Anyways, okay, so this is your seventh year in the league. Like, you, what, did 5 years with San Francisco with the Niners, and then
correct,
last year was your first year with Cincinnati, which was a freaking awesome year.
Correct, thank you.
Yeah.
Also, I would like to add on to that, that was my first time, last year was my first time ever going to the playoffs.
Woohoo! That's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. So you can imagine how Houston felt when they saw me line up against them, and I'm all smiles and grin, yet I'm tackling somebody. Like, why are you smiling at me? Look, I'm in the playoffs. This is my first time.
I'm just happy to be here, buddy. Oh my gosh. Okay, when you first started in the league, were there any particular rituals that you did to help you prepare for the games that you've realized that, hey, they kind of stay with you and you still do that to this day?
I would have to say one is always listening to music, having my headphones on. I have to listen to a Busta Rhymes song. Actually, I have to listen to several of them. And then some Michael Jackson songs. And then other artists. Lil Wayne, Eminem.
Okay.
I'll throw in a little bit of R&B in between, like for stretching when I'm stretching. You know, because you don't want to be like listening to rap and whatnot. You know, real upbeat, high tempo songs while you're stretching, because you could probably pull a muscle.
Right. Over there doing stanky leg while you doing, you know, right leg stretch.
I know. Yeah. So you don't want to do that. So you have to, you know, just calm it down a little bit. You know, give a nice little R&B, like three R&B songs in there. That's what, maybe 10 minutes. Proper stretching, and then get right back to it with a Busta Rhymes. Put your hands where my eyes can see.
Okay. With your arm, you really try to tell your quarterback, put that ball where I can see. Well, you play defense, so yeah, but I get what you're saying.
Well, he can put their opposing quarterback can put the ball
there
where I can
you go.
See.
That's right. There you go.
I don't mind that at all. Yeah. And I prefer it like where I can see within, you know, within my area. Like, I don't want them to score and I see that. I want that they can throw me the ball.
They can throw you the ball. You get that. And you are like totally known for like your tackles and stuff. Like does that determine a good game for you, the amount of tackles you get, or you rather have a win? Like, which one?
I would much rather take a win any day.
That is so awesome.
Any day of the week. It doesn't matter how much I played, how little I played, what my stats were. Because half the time, I don't even know my stats. Actually, all the time, I never know my stats. And I just rather have a win.
That is so awesome. There is no I in team. You know what? You kind of just said that right now. There is no I in team.
You know what? There isn't. There really isn't.
Yeah, that's awesome.
It would really suck if there was an I in team, because that means it's just you against 11 other people. Oh, that is not pretty. Like, when you, like, visualize that, that is not pretty.
Well, and speaking of pretty, I see you trying to be all grown with your beard.
Thank you. Yes, thank
what,
you.
What's up with this beard?
Crazy. You know, I try. I would have to say I use my own natural juices and berries. You know, just let it do what it do. Yes, good genes. I will also have to thank God, you know, for blessing me with all the many blessings, especially, you know, good looks. Thank you. You don't have to, like, say that on national TV.
On radio. You're funny. They can see your picture. Yeah. So they know what I'm talking about. They know what I'm talking about.
Okay. That's good. We can do that.
We'll thank Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. How about that?
Yes, we have to. We have to.
Now, I've known you. I know you are just an amazing person. And how have you just managed to stay out of the news and the drama? Because almost all the NFL players at some way make their way down to L.A. or Vegas. And then the next thing you know, you hear them on the news because they got a DUI or they done headbutted somebody. Like, how have you been able to stay out of the news and the drama? Or at least I should say our L.A. news and our TMZ, because maybe you getting in it in Cincinnati. I don't know, but I haven't.
No. I have a strict routine. It's, one, watch lots of movies. Two, go to restaurants, eat healthy to where you get the itis. I mean, not healthy, but eat a lot to where you get the itis, and the only thing on your mind is sleeping. Three, video games, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And then some other hobbies as, you know, bowling.
Oh, my God, you sleeping. Still do bowling.
Yes, I do. I am a good bowler.
Oh, wait. Can I just tell my audience, okay, you guys, me and Manny went bowling one time in San Francisco, and he showed up with his own ball and his own shoes, like professional.
You better believe it. Okay. You better believe it. I have a jersey, too.
Oh, you didn't bust out the jersey.
No, because people are not ready for the jersey. And plus, I'm not really ready for the jersey because it's kind of small. So I just, you know, just keep it, you know, just like hanging up.
Oh, that's cool. So you just partake in, like, your hobbies and your stuff. That's how you stay out of the drama.
That's it. You know, and whenever, you know, you are in a place that is starting to get a little rowdy,
mm-hmm.
go ahead and leave because it's not worth it. It's really not worth it. You'll lose a lot more than what you think you may gain.
Mm-hmm. And then when you go out too, I try to tell people, like the guys that I know that are youngsters in the leagues, I always tell them, you know, if you're gonna go out and party, get a driver. You know, have a designated person. Yeah.
By all means, get a driver. Make sure you have a designated driver whom you trust that, you know, will not drink, will be what is a designated driver, mm-hmm. and will, you know, monitor what you drink, make sure you get home. Gotta have somebody like that with you.
Yeah, always. You're so right. Totally right. Now, I want to tell my audience a little like fact about you they probably don't know. Or, if they went online and did some research, they could find out. So, you also did track and football in college. Like, you're super athletic, but you're very smart. You majored in engineering, industrial engineering, I might add. Correct?
Correct.
Okay, yeah, so where was that going to go? Where were you going to go with that? Like, were you going to go, like, build a railroad or something? I'm just saying.
Well, see, this is, like, what happened was...
Industrial engineering, that is engineering in general. Then let alone put industrial in front of it, Manny. Like, seriously, that's intense.
What happened was, upon me getting my scholarship, I was able to, you know, get a dual, was able to be a dual athlete. And my school of choice was North Carolina State, which has a great architectural program.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I really wanted to do. So, you know, when you get there, you start taking your little classes, and then when, you know, you get to decide, okay, this is the major, I already knew. So when I went in there and I was like, you know, I want to be an architect, It was like, okay, cool. Well, you know, being that I had a football scholarship and then, you know, with architecture, you have to do studio hours. That would have required me to either miss a lot of school or miss a lot of practices.
Right.
And it would have been hard to do both. So I just really, like, closed my eyes and drew the circle with my finger and just landed on my next appointed major, which is industrial engineering.
Really?
Yeah. So I just picked it.
Oh, okay.
Without even looking.
Oh, my gosh. That's funny.
I'm really not going to do anything with it.
Oh, my gosh. So you don't see yourself using that degree for nothing?
No. I mean, you know, just wall space. It looks nice on the wall.
Oh, my gosh.
No. That's about it, though.
That's funny.
I'm going to see if I can find a way to get back into architecture.
Yeah, I'm sure you can. I mean, maybe you could take some classes online or, you know, or something. Everything's online now. I mean, you could play football online.
No, you cannot, for the most part.
I'm sure University of Phoenix got like an online football team.
I was thinking about that. What if I went back to school and, you know, got a degree in architect? Well, it's like now, like, if I go back to school, like, my school done changed a lot. I've changed.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel all out of place.
Yeah. To leave homework and then to go back to do it, just that, that seems like a struggle.
Exactly.
You know, that's probably a little more challenging.
Man,
yeah.
I don't want to do this.
Yeah. It's probably easier if you just tackle people.
It really is, because it's really like almost no thinking. Just run around, hit somebody with the ball. That's it.
Does your team, oh my God, I kind of know where I'm going with this. Because you said it's just, it's so easy, just run around and hit somebody. Do you get extra incentives if you hit somebody a little harder than normal? Or
no,
do you
get extra incentives?
There, you mean the Bengals don't have a bounty program?
No, we do not.
You mean you don't get no extra bonuses when you do them forced fumbles?
Well, that's different.
Okay.
To like, you know, create forced fumbles or get a certain amount of tackles or get a certain amount of sacks. You know, there's incentives for that.
Okay.
But, you know, to go out and, you know, have a hit list, there is no incentive.
Yeah, that's okay. That's nice to know. It's nice to know some teams are actually practicing good NFL conduct. I'm just saying.
I hear you. I'm just saying. I hear you.
Oh, my gosh. Okay, wait. So, you know, you are such a likable person, so I'm sure you have so many NFL buddies and stuff. Do you, like, call your buddies up who play on other teams and, like, talk crap when they lose or something? Do you do that?
No, well, unless we're playing them.
Unless you're playing them.
Yes. Like, if you take a loss by another team, you know, I'll watch you. If I can catch the game, I'll watch the game and critique you if you ask. Or, you know, be like, you know, I saw this great play that you made. That's about it for the most part. But if we play each other, oh, you better believe the moment, because I really only know what team we're playing that week.
Uh-huh.
And then once we, you know, have that game, then I'll know who I play next. Other than that, you couldn't tell me who I play after Baltimore. That's all I know.
Really?
I know I have Baltimore first regular season game. That's about it.
You don't check your schedules in advance?
No, I can't do that. I mean, I can check it, but it's like, you know, go in one ear, go out the other.
Okay, okay. So you're just like really in the moment, like the game. So right now, you only care about Green Bay Packers.
Right, that's it. Right,
that's
now.
All. All you see is green and yellow.
Yeah, and that's you know, those aren't even my favorite colors.
Okay.
No, they're not.
You're silly. Anyway, oh my gosh. Wait, how is it Coach Lewis, I should say?
He's a great coach. He's a people coach. He's a players coach, and you want to know? I think he has moments to where he doesn't know what to do with himself, because you can see, you know, Coach Lewis running from offensive line to linebackers and DBs and to the running backs,
yeah,
to the tight ends, to the receivers, you know, and coaching us all. Like, I really do think he misses, you know, his old position coaching days, because I think he actually gets more of a workout than we do because he runs around so much.
Oh, my God. He looks so cool. Like, I always, when I watch him on TV, I'm like, gosh, that guy looks so cool. Like, I know me and him would, like, have a blast doing some karaoke or something. You know, he just seems like a really cool guy.
I don't think, but you would have to hit the high notes if y'all did a duet, because I don't think Coach Lewis, you know, really has the high notes.
So do you talk to him like every day?
Oh, we always talk every day.
Okay.
All the time. Most of the time is, you know, him telling me, you know, or, you know, us having a session on me, you know, dropping at this angle. It's really not a discussion. He's just telling me this. But no, we talk every so often, you know, and it's not even really about football. He asks, you know, how your family's doing, you know, how you're adjusting, especially for, you know, the young guys, the rookies that are coming in. How are you adjusting? Have you found a place? Do you
right.
need some help? Always, you know, making sure that his players are, you know, taken care of.
Oh, that's so nice. That's really cool. Do you, because I know you guys have, obviously you have rookies, but I don't know if you have any rookie linebackers, but do you kind of take any of the rookies under your wing and say, hey, you know, make sure you do A, B, and C, don't do E, F, and G? Like, do you do that? Do you act like a mentor, act as a mentor for some of the players?
We do have rookies, linebackers, and I would say that, you know, I was just thinking about this the other day, that we're a very good team. We have very well-spoken vets. You know, vets that's, you know, not like back in the days, you always had to carry the vest pads.
Mm-hmm.
So we have vets that, you know, will talk to you, will spend time with you, will work with you after practice, will work with you doing things, you know, will actually try to make you better in coming in to play in this game.
Oh, good.
Even if you're, you know, coming here to replace us, you know, we still will still work with you. So, yes, I would say for myself and for several of the other vets on our team, you know, we are always helping and looking out for our young guys.
Oh, that's good. Well, ain't nobody replacing
Man,
you.
That makes me sound so old.
No, you're not old. You're a veteran.
I know, right?
Yeah, you're a veteran just because of the years you have in the league, but you're not old at all. Yeah.
Man, a rookie called me an OG the other day. I was like, wait a minute.
Oh, my gosh. That's when you tell them to carry your bag and stuff. Hey, pick up my bag, buddy.
I couldn't think of anything fast enough. Well, I'm going to say drop down and give me 30.
Oh, my gosh. You're funny. Well, I just want to say thank you so much for taking time out to talk to me. It has been a while since I've, like, verbally talked to you. Like, we've texted and all of that and emailed, but haven't been able to, like, get on the phone and actually chit-chat.
You know what? And it's good to hear your voice. I really do thank you for hitting me up.
Yeah, of course. Now, don't think I don't know y'all's schedule. You might not look in advance, but I do. And I know y'all is coming out here in San Diego in December sometime to play the Chargers. So, yeah, just wink, wink through the phone. Wink, wink.
Uh-huh. You send the little wink. emoticons.
What did you say?
What do they call it, emocon?
I don't know what they're called, but you might be right.
It's something like that.
Okay, yeah. Well, I just sent a wink through the phone line, so I expect to be seeing you in December when y'all play the Chargers. That's all I'm saying.
We will make it happen.
Well. So yeah. So Manny, do you have any parting words to the Lady J's listening audience? Because they're all really big fan of yours. I've been pumping you up.
Oh. Well, wow. Well, thank you so much. You know, I've been put on the spot, so I'm speechless. I really do appreciate the support. I hope you continue watching myself, and also continue listening to Lady J. She's a great person, and I mean, you'll never find one like her. So thank you all.
Aww, you're gonna make me cry.
Oh, girl, you better not.
Oh my gosh, that's awesome. So this has been Lady J with the Lady J's Wild World of Sports. I'm so honored I got a chance to talk to my buddy, Mr. Manny Lawson, number 99, linebacker for the Cincinnati Bengals. And we're going to wish him so much luck against the Green Bay Packers. All righty. So, yay. Hey, this is Lady J. I just want to say, everyone, thank you for tuning in to Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live. Join me next week as I have my first Fans Day. So this is Lady J's Wild World of Sports here on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk. Okay. And thank you to my sponsors, Mix Chicks, and all my guests, Dan Tana and Lashinda Demons, the Olympic silver medalists in the 400-meter hurdles.